Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of DaVinci Resolve on the Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily use our DaVinci Resolve video editor to edit any videos. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee you this video is going to be very informative for you. And if you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install DaVinci Resolve, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to just simply search over here DaVinci Resolve download and hit enter. And immediately you'll be seeing this DaVinci Resolve 18 as a first source link. So you need to click on this www.blackmagicdesign.com. So once you click on that, it's going to redirect to the official site of DaVinci Resolve. So this link I'm going to put right in our description, so you can directly use that link to land over here, and you can see that our latest version of DaVinci Resolve is DaVinci Resolve 18. Alright, so it is scroll down and you'll be able to see DaVinci Resolve 18 over here. So you can see we have this download button, so you need to click on this and it will show you this DaVinci Resolve 18.6 version, which is latest version at the time of making of the video. So if you are watching this video much later, maybe you'll be seeing version 18.7 or even version 19. So if I see any major difference on the installation steps, then I'm surely going to make another video. But for now, you can totally trust this video. So you can see that our DaVinci Resolve 18.6 is there, and then DaVinci Resolve Studio is also there. The DaVinci Resolve Studio is a paid one, so they have more features, including AI and all, but this DaVinci Resolve is a up cost. Alright, so you can use it for both Mac, Windows, Linux and all this operating system. So you can see all these links is also available over here. So you need to click on this window and it's going to show you this form. So you need to fill your details. So fill your first name, last name, your company, email ID, phone number, your country, your state, city, all of that you need to put over here, and put your pin code as well. And then you need to after register, then you need to download. Alright, so I have already downloaded it, so unnecessary I will not going to fill the form and waste time. So if you go to my download directory, you can see already that same version is downloaded over here, and the file size is, you can see, 2 GB, right? So you need to have like that much amount of bandwidth to download the entire file. So the file will be a zip file, so you need to right click and to extract this onto over here. So you see our extraction is rightly began, so let's extract it over here. So you can see that our file is rightly extracted, and here is our exe. So this within this extracted folder we have the exe lying over here. Right, so to double click on the installer in order to install DaVinci Resolve on your Windows operating system. So you can see that it is rightly started extracting our DaVinci Resolve. So let's wait for a couple of minutes, and you can see it is rightly extracted and it will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and there you go, DaVinci Resolve installer is rightly opened over here. So let's first minimize our download directory. So here you can see that our installation wizard is rightly open, so it's going to install all these libraries, packages, everything. So keep this default and click on install. So it's going to install our Microsoft Visual C++ 2013 redistributable version, and then it's going to install DaVinci control panels. So let's wait for some time, and after that it will show you welcome to DaVinci Resolve setup wizard. So just simply click on next over here. So these are our license agreement, you need to accept the license agreement and then you need to click on next. So this is where our DaVinci Resolve is going to be installed. You can keep this default, or if you want to change it to some other location, so that also you can do. You need to just simply click on change and you need to browse that folder over here, but I'm going to keep this default over here. I'll click on next. So see, it's ready to be installed. Click on install, and there you go, you can see our installation is rightly began. Right, so it will take some time, about 5 minutes I would say. So you can grab some tea or coffee, whichever you like, and then you can again come back to this video. Yep, so we'll come back And now you can clearly see that our DaVinci Resolve is successfully installed. So you can just simply click on finish over here. So you can see also our desktop shortcut is created over here, and it is telling to complete the installation you must restart your system. So now let's click on yes and restart our system, and after that I am going to again back to this video. So welcome back once again guys. So I have successfully restarted my system, and again we are back to our Windows. So you know, let's double click on the shortcut to launch our DaVinci Resolve. And you can see that our DaVinci Resolve is rightly launched. So you can always read more about all these features. You can always click on learn more to learn more about all the different features that DaVinci Resolve will give us. So you can always read that. For now I'll just simply click on continue over here. So great, you are almost there. You can always click on quick setup to learn all the basic steps. Don't worry, I'm going to show you all of that on this video. So I'll go to click on skip and start now. So that will directly launch our DaVinci Resolve. So you can see our DaVinci Resolve 18.6 version is rightly started launching. So it will ask you to give this permission. So you need to click on allow over here. And you can see that our DaVinci Resolve is rightly opened over here. And this is the interface of our DaVinci Resolve. Alright. So here in the bottom, if you see, we have all these different menus. So we have a media, then we have a cut, and then we have edit, fusion, color, fair light, and then we have a deliver, right? So now I'm going to switch to this edit part, and then I'm going to right click over here, and then I'm going to click on import media. So you want to import one video. So on my video directory, you can see we have a video like intro mkb file. So I'll just simply double click to import the file, click on change. So that video file will be imported over here, and then I'm going to edit that video. All right so you can see that our video is at imported. So let's click on the video and then drag it over here, and you can see that our video is rightly added over here. So you can always move this pointer to change the frame. And you can always click on this minus icon to shrink the timeline over here. So you can see it is properly synced now. Let's say you want to cut some of this area. So you can always click on this desired icon. And then you need to put the pointer like from here till here. Maybe you want to cut. So you need to place that over here. That in the first section, then the end section. And then you need to select the entire part that you want to delete. And then hit the delete button on your keyboard, and immediately you can see that from this portion to this portion is deleted, right? So if I move on to the effect section, so if I click on effect over here, you can see we have lot of video transitions available. You can see, right? So all different video transitions are available. You can always click one of that, and you can put that over here. You can always expand this. You can see here one video transition is added, right? So if you move your pointer and then if you play the video, you can see a transition is happening. Clearly you can see that, right? So it got separated from middle, and then it transitioned into next screen. So you can do experiment with all these different transitions that are available over here. So these are all you can use. Some of them are paid ones, so you can click on not yet, but all these different transitions you can use. Alright, so you can also use audio transitions as well. You can always give some title. So let's say you want to give some title, like maybe on lower third, you can add, like you drag and drop that, and here if I play this, you can see that something is coming up over here, but that's a white in color. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the I'm going to click the select, and then I'm going to select the text, and then I'm going to click on inspect over here, and here, and I'll change this color to black, and I'll also change the color for the below one, that is the sample one, also black. And now if I play this, you'll be able to see that a title is coming on the lower third, right? So that's how you can add titles. You can also use different type of effects, all that. You can also use green screen, then you can remove that green screen background. All of that you can do on DaVinci Resolve. Alright, so now the scope is, you know, beyond any limitations. You can do a lot of things on DaVinci Resolve. Alright, and once you are done with your editing, so when you are done completely with the editing, then you'll want to export the video, right? So for that, what you can do is you need to switch to this deliver tab, and once you are here, it will going to, you know, show you this form over here. So you need to give a file name. So let's give the file name as intro final. So our, you know, introduction video is edited, so we are naming it like intro final, and we are going to choose a format over here. So format currently they have selected by default is QuickTime. You can change it to any format from here. So you can choose MP4, you can choose, you know, MKV, whichever you want, right? I'm going to choose MP4, and you know, all other things are fine. You can also choose the resolution from here if you want to, you know, export it in a 4K format. So that also you can do. All right, so you need to select this one, so that will export in a 4K format, or you want to, you know, change the frame rate, so that also you can do. For now it is 60. It also depends upon the source video, right? If a video source is, you know, just suit on maybe 24 fps, then you can't increase the frame rate, so it will be within 24, right? But if a video is shoot on 60 fps or 120 fps, then you can, you know, really make that slow-mo, all that on, you know, DaVinci Resolve. All right, so now you need to put a comment in your comment section that you really need a little tutorial on DaVinci Resolve about various, you know, tricks and tips. If you want, you need to put that comment in your comment section. I'll be happily make a video on that as well. So I know if you need that video, then I'll surely going to make, but I unnecessarily don't want to make this video too long. So what I'm going to show you next is that you can, you know, give your file name over here, and then what type of export you want. If you want to export in like H.264 master, or you want to just simply export for YouTube, so you know, you need to switch then to all these different tabs. So if you, you know, scroll this, you can see that we have Vimeo, Twitter, TikTok, you know, all these different platforms it is showing, right? So you know, from here you can, you know, choose any of the platform, or you can just simply do custom export, and then you need to click on this add to render queue. So as soon as you click on that, it will show you that on which folder you want to save this video. So I'm going to choose the default, the video folder that they have selected. So I'll click on save, and immediately under render queue you'll be able to see that intro final.mp4 file which we want to export are properly listed over here, right? So after it get listed, then it will click on render all, and it's going to start, you know, exporting our video. That final version of the edited video going to be exported onto this location, and you can see that it will take like about 3.5 minutes, right? So below 4 minutes it will take. So you know, it depends upon the, your system capability, also the length of the video. So if you are using i3 or i5, so it varies from system to system, right? This entire rendering process. All right, so in this way I can easily install DaVinci Resolve on a Windows operating system. I have also showed you how you can easily import a video, how to edit a video. I have also showed you a bit about transition and all. So now you can always comment in your comment sections if you need more videos on DaVinci Resolve, or you can also subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. So here I am posting regularly coding related videos, and if you are interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script vlogging channel. So here you can see I have made one video. So we recently went to Kashmir, so you can see we have this and a beautiful text effect that we have created like 2023 to 2024. So all this I have done on DaVinci Resolve itself. All right, so if you need a little tutorial on how I made this, you can always comment. I'll be happy to make such videos as well. All right, so you know, that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.